Hi everyone, and welcome to the channel. And today we're gonna have a little bit of a science experiment. Oh, shoot, too foamy. Oh goodness, gosh, goodness. I just had those on for dramatic effect. So one of the biggest questions I've always had is the selling of quick dry or technical underwear. Does it really dry faster? Is it any better than your standard underwear out there, which would be mostly a 100% cotton or natural fiber or an actual silky nylon, which a lot of the technical underwear is made out of this nylon. And then not only that, what percentage inclusion, because a lot of the underwear has the elastic in it, would be the best in terms of drying capability, and how much faster does it dry than a cotton underwear? So what I have behind me is various different types, from a 100% cotton to different percentage of nylon to a polyester technical underwear. So the question today is, does quick dry underwear really dry that quickly? Now, the design of our experiment today will be this. One, I will weigh each of the pairs of, why is it pairs? Pair of underwear. I'll weigh each of the undies on a dry weight basis. Then I'll add about 240 milliliters or one cup of water to each and let it sit 5 minutes to see how much that underwear piece absorbs. Then I will wring out the underwear and weigh it again and see how much it weighs. And then we will hang to dry. So we will take measurements at the first 30 minutes, then an hour, then 60 minutes, therefore, until the first piece of underwear actually reaches its original dry weight. And then we'll see which one actually dries the fastest and if it is a percentage of that nylon or if it's the fact that it is a synthetic versus a natural fiber. So here we go, science time. So I've organized 6 different types of underwear according to their hydrophilic or hydrophobic property. So hydrophilic, meaning that they love to absorb water, and this would be your not quick drying underwear. To the hydrophobic, which means that they don't like water and they're not gonna absorb water, and this would be your quick weigh, quick dry technical fabric. So on the left here would be a Hanes 100% cotton underwear. Next up, we have an icebreaker, which actually is a blend of 83% merino wool and a 12% nylon blend. So it is not only a natural fiber in there, but we also have a synthetic fiber. Then we'll have our Under Armour 68% nylon, our Patagonia 88% nylon, our Ex Officio, which is one of the most popular technical underwears out there, at a 94% nylon, and our Patagonia Brief, which is an 88% polyester. And one of the most common things about a nylon and polyester versus a natural fabric is also going to be, or a natural fiber, I'll say, is going to be that there's an odor resistance with these synthetic fibers. Is going to be the odor. There's a lot of companies out there now that are actually incorporating some type of silver into these synthetic fibers to help with that odor resistance. But overall, a synthetic fiber like a polyester actually has an oleophilic property, which means it actually likes oils. So that's why, one of the reasons why it also smells too, is that it loves to absorb your body odor, which is kind of gross. And then with nylon, is actually very popular within underwear because it also can absorb, not only just wick away, moisture and specifically water. And so it can absorb a little bit just like a natural fiber. So that's why they tend to use it more on the undergarments versus something like a shirt or a hoodie that you might see that has the wicking properties. So let's start our experiment. The Hanes weighing in at 0.96 ounces, the icebreaker weighing in at 0.6 ounces, the Under Armour weighing in at 0.72 ounces, and the Patagonia weighing in at 0.68 ounces, and Ex Officio weighing in at 0.6 ounces, and the Patagonia Poly Brief weighing in at 0.96 ounces. But let's go ahead, add some water, and let's see how much they absorb. Okay, so just quickly did our absorption test, and with the Hanes 100% cotton, it absorbs 79% of its weight in water. The Icebreaker 8312 Merino Nylon Blend absorbs 67% of its weight in water. The Under Armour 68% Nylon absorbs 50% of its weight in water. The Patagonia 88% Nylon absorbed 82% of its weight in water. The Ex Officio, the 94% Nylon Blend, came in at 23% absorption its weight in water, and the Patagonia up 88% poly brief came in at 66% of its weight in water. So let's get them hung to dry over here on this back panel and see how long they take to dry. So I'm actually interrupting this video, and you might have noticed the slight wardrobe and hair change. It's because I ended up having to do, I would say I didn't really have to do, but I ended up wanting to do this experiment over the course of 3 days. And that's because after the first time I did it, I realized I might have a little bit different definition of the term quick. So my expectation was that a quick dry underwear would dry within 3 to 4 hours, and that totally was not the case. So what I did was just repeat this experiment over the course of 3 days, and here's my summary and the results. So one, as I mentioned earlier, I was definitely surprised that these did not dry out, even the ones that say they are quick dry, within 3 to 4 hours. Versus our control, quick dry underwear definitely dried quicker than 100% cotton underwear, but I would not classify it as quick. Now the conditions in which we were running, basically anywhere from 62 to 65 degrees Fahrenheit, and this is my basement, and then the humidity was between 30 to 34% across the 3 days, so not too much in terms of changing in the environment. And you also have to take into consideration if you are out on trail and it's a hot day, it's gonna evaporate faster. If you live in a more humid climate, it's gonna have a harder time evaporating faster. If you've got wind blowing through it, again, it's gonna dry a lot quicker, but these were the conditions in which I did this experiment. So number two, versus the control, everything except that 88% poly brief dried quicker, which also says to me that not only is the material and composition important, but also the design of the underwear and whether or not it had sort of a mesh backing, if it was really thick. But the poly brief actually ended up drying slower than the 100% cotton brief. And then three, for the best performing out of all of the underwear, was the Icebreaker Merino Nylon Blend. And here are the final results. So our control, the Hanes 100% cotton underwear, absorbed 179% of its water weight. The average amount absorbed was 1.69 ounces once I did wring it out. The average water evaporation per hour was 0.19 ounces per hour. And then the average hours to dry was 9.14 hours. For the Icebreaker, which was the 88% merino wool, 12% nylon blend, it absorbed 167% of its weight in water. The average amount absorbed in terms of water was 0.96 ounces. The average evaporation loss per hour was 0.17 ounces per hour. And the average hours it took to dry was 5.94 hours. So that was the number one winner in our category of quick dry underwear. Then we had the Under Armour Stretch Hipster, which was a 68% nylon that absorbed 181% of its weight in water. The average amount absorbed was 1.12 ounces. The average evaporation loss per hour was 0.20 ounces per hour. And the average hours it took to dry was 5.68 hours. Now, I didn't classify that one as a winner just because the variability in the amount it took to dry was considerably more than the Icebreaker underwear, which had a more consistent, but a little bit higher average. And then the Patagonia Barely Brief at an 88% nylon absorbed 182% of its weight in water. The average amount absorbed was 1.24 ounces. The average evaporation loss was 0.18 ounces per hour, and the average hours it took to dry was 6.77 hours. The Ex Officio, if that is really how you say it, which I think it is, which is a 94% nylon, absorbed 124% of its weight in water. And that was the other one that actually absorbed the least amount per dry weight in water. It absorbed an average of 0.84 ounces. It took an average of 0.12 ounces an hour to dry. Now, it was the lightest in terms of absorption, but also did not evaporate as quickly per hour as the other underwear. And the average hours it took to dry was 7.24 hours. And then kind of bringing up the rear, which is our worst performing brief, is a Patagonia Poly Brief, which is an 88% polyester blend. Now, it absorbed 167% of its weight in water. The average amount of water it absorbed was 1.60 ounces. Average evaporation loss per hour was 0.16 ounces per hour. And the average hours it took to dry was 10.29 hours. hours. So overall, the average underwear did dry quicker than a 100% cotton brief. However, I would not classify it as a quick dry underwear. So some things to keep in mind when you're searching for that technical underwear is one, the ratio of the blend, the wool nylon blend seem to perform the best, but it is also the most expensive. And then the stuff that was actually a lower percentage of polyester with the stretch elastic, elastane, or if you have a different type of stretch material in it, actually performed better. And then also keep in mind if it's got airway to breathe, if it's a little bit meshy of a material, that will help it dry a lot quicker. So anyways, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video and got something useful out of it or found it a little bit entertaining at least. And if you did, please consider subscribing to my channel. I talk all about hiking, backpacking, camping, and just your general life adventures with you and your dog. Thanks for watching.